Hello everyone. Today we will learn that how to create EC2 instance, right? And the root volume of that EC2 instance can be shared, right? Can be attached with some other instance. Okay. So for that purpose, what I will do, I will create two EC2 instance. In one EC2 instance, I will connect to that instance. I will save some file. I'll create some file and all. And for the other EC2 instance, I will make the instance and I'll not do anything with that instance, right? Then I will show you when I'll interchange the root volume of both the instance, how it will look like, okay? So I'm just going to perform that task today. So we can exchange the root volume, right? That is possible. But once root volume is attached to one instance, that root volume cannot be attached to some other instance, right? First, you need to detach that volume from one instance, then you can attach that volume to some other instance, right? So at one point of time, you can use one ABS volume, root volume with only one instance. But that volume can be used by some other instance also, but at one point of time, only one instance can use that. So I'm just going to EC2 dashboard and I'll create two EC2 instance, right? So right now no instance is in running condition, but I'll create two EC2 instance one by one, right? So I'm just going to here launch instance and I'll create EC2 1, and for the other one I will provide name EC2 2. So two Windows instance I'm creating. Key pair information, so I am creating one key pair EC21KP, right? And I will create key pair and I will create one security group where I am allowing HTTP connection from anywhere, and apart from that I need not to do anything. So I will launch instance. Okay, now after this one I will launch one more instance. Okay, and I'll provide name to that instance as EC2 2. Okay, and I will again create Microsoft Windows instance and I will create one new key pair and I will provide name to that new key pair is EC2 2 KP, and I will create this key pair. Now after this one, what I'll do, I will allow security group connection. I will allow connection to this EC2 instance from web anywhere, right? And RDP connection from anywhere. Now I will launch this instance. Now two instance I have created, right? And these two instance will be in running condition after some point of time. Okay, so I'm just going to wait for a few seconds so that these two instance must be in running condition. Okay, so you can see here these two instances are in running condition now, right? Now I will connect to first instance, right? I am just connecting to first instance and I am saving password of this instance. So I will download remote desktop file and I'll get password for this instance. I need to provide PPK file for this one and after this one, what I'll do, I'll decrypt this password. Okay, so I got this password. So I will copy this password and I'll save it my okay. So what I'm just going to do. Okay, so this PPK this password is for EC21, right? I'm just showing this one so that I'll remember later on. Now I will connect with this file, okay, and I will create one folder here for showing some change, right, for both the EC2 instance. So I'm connecting to this instance. so I will be connected with this instance. Okay, so this one is the instance. So I will create one folder, and I'm writing the name of that EBS volume kind of thing, right? EBS volume. Okay, to show that EB2 1 instance EBS volume is different than the other one, right? So nothing else. I'm not doing anything else. I'm disconnecting from here. Now I will go to second instance, and I will note down the password of to connect this instance also. Okay. So I'm just going to RDP client. I will download remote desktop file. I will get password by uploading the .pm file. I am decrypting the password. I am using the password. Okay. So we have done till here. So I am not connecting to this instance because I don't want to do any changes with the this instance, right? Okay. Now I want to detach volume of these two instances, and I want to interchange EBS volume. So if you just go to volumes, there will be two volume available, right? And what I'll do, I will interchange the volume. Okay, so how it will be possible? So I need to check, right, which volume is associated with which instance. So you can see here the first one, right? This volume is associated with EC21. So what I'll do, I'll write here EBS21. Okay, now after some time I will interchange this volume with some other, with each other, you can say 22. Okay, these two volume, both the volume are in use, right? And where it is attached with these two instance. Now to interchange this volume, I want to assign this EBS volume to EC2E1 instance, and I want to assign this EBS volume to EC22 instance. So we cannot do it directly, right? First we need to detach these two EBS volume, but this is not possible when your instance is in running condition. Suppose I want to detach, right, these two volume, so it will not allow me. Why? Because both the instance, right, this one and this one is in running condition. So if you want to detach root volume, in that case you need to make the instances in stop condition. Do not terminate it, right? Otherwise your EBS volume will be lost. Now I will make these two instances is in stop condition, right? After this one, I can detach the volume, EBS volume, from one instance and attach that EBS volume to some other instance. Okay, so that is possible. Okay, so this one is in a stopping condition. After some time, it will be in stopped condition. Okay, both are in a stopping condition. Okay, so one is stopped, EC221 is stopped, but EC222 is not stopped. Now I will go to volumes, and I will detach the volume that is available with these two EBS volume. So I am detaching these two volume. So again, for the case of instance EC22, right, it is not allowing me. Why? Because it is attached with my EC2 instance, right? So you can see here one volume that is was allocated to EC2121. It is in available condition now, but second one is in use condition. Okay, so I need to check the status of EC2 instance, right? I'm just going to instances here. I'm just going to check. So this one is still a stopping condition, right? So I need to wait for some time so that it will become in stopped condition, right? So I'm just waiting for a few seconds. Okay, so now you can see both the instances are in stopped condition. So now I can go to volume, right? Now I can detach to other volume also. So I'm just going to action and I'm going to detach volume. So now it will be detached. Okay, now you can see both the volumes will be in available condition, means these volumes can be used. Now I want to attach this volume to EC22 and I want to attach this volume to EC21. So just go here, go to action and attach volume, right? So I need to provide here name. So I want to connect this EBS volume. So this EBS volume is EBS21. So I will connect to EC22, right? I'm interchanging that. And device name will be this one. So if you are using Windows instance, so device names will be this one. Okay, so just provide this device name because root volume is created on this physical device. So this one is coming in use condition. Now just go to this EBS volume and connect this EBS volume to the first instance. So instance name should be EC21. And now device name will again be same. Dev SD1. Now attach volume. Now try to launch EC2 instance. Right now make the EC2 instances in. So now start these two EC2 instance. Now both the EC2 instance will be with different EBS volume. Why? Because we have interchanged the volume. Now I'm starting the EC2 instance. It will take some time to get started. So till the time I will wait, and then once it will start, I will start the video. Okay, so these two instances are in running condition, right? So now I will try to connect with EC21. So I'm just going to connect with this instance. So I have already RDP client available, right? So what I'll do, I will go to EC2 RDP. Now I will connect, right? Okay, just cancel this one. Go to RDP client. Go to RDP client and download remote desktop file. Okay. Now, if you try to get password, just go. Here, don't create password because we have already password available with us, right? So I have saved both the password. So I'm just going to RDP this RDP file. I will try to connect. Okay. It will ask me one password. So for EC21, earlier I was using this password, right? If I use same password, it will not allow me to connect. We need to use password of the other one, right? EC222, because EBS volume of the second instance is connected to the first one, right? So if you go and paste that password, so it will work, right? And you will see that no folder will be available here. Why? Because in this for the second EBS volume, I didn't create any folder, right? For the first EBS volume, I created folder, so that will be visible. So after some time, you will see here no folder is available. Okay, so you can see here no folder is available, right? Now I will connect to the folder that was created earlier with the first instance will be available for the case of second instance, right? Now I'm just going to connect with this instance and I will download RDP client and I will connect with that. And for the password case, as I told you, we will paste the password of the previous one, right? This one. So I'm pasting this one. Now you will see the folder will be available here. The folder that I was created earlier will be available in this case also. You can see this folder is available, right? Earlier it was created with EC21, EC21 instance, and the EBS volume of EC21 instance is attached with EC22. So that's why this folder is available here, right? So I'm disconnecting with this information, and then I'll show you. Then that is the assignment, today's assignment. So one EBS volume can be attached with one EC2 instance. Now I just want to terminate these two instances. So once I will terminate these two instances, EBS volume of corresponding instance will be terminated or deleted, right? So in the case of the stop condition, EBS volume remains with us, right? But those EBS volume will be started in some other hardware, right? So the hardware where the virtual machine created earlier will not be seen once you see. Okay, so I deleted EC2 instance, but EBS volumes are not deleted, right? So in this case, what we need to do, I need to delete EC2 instance, EBS volume separately, right? So what you need to do, just go to volumes, because I have not selected that option, EBS volume should be deleted once it is deleted from, once EC2 instance is deleted, right? Now I will delete EBS22 volume also. So, okay, so first it is asking to detach, right? So just refresh this one, so it will be in available condition. So it is showing that it is in use condition, right? Why it is showing like that? Because if you go to EC2 instance, so the instance is shutting down, it is not terminated, right? So after some time it will be terminated, and you will be able to see that will not be in use condition. Now you can see all the instances are in terminated state. Now you can go to EBS volume, and you need to remove this volume, right? Okay, so whatever, snapshot is not available. So we need to pay for snapshot, we need to pay for volume, we need to pay for AMI. So all these things are deleted. And if you go to EC2 instance also, the instance is also in terminated condition, right? So no instance is in running condition. That's what we wanted. Okay, so that's all about today's lab. So in today's lab, what we did, we created two EC2 instance, and we swapped EBS volume of those instance, right? And we showed how it worked.